Going great.
What's the competition like at running back for you guys?
It's a beautiful situation. You always want competition because competition is always going to bring out the best in every man that is wanting to compete to be a starter.
How is Michael fit in? How did you address that situation? I guess
we addressed it straight on, as you would expect from this staff from the very beginning. So he knew what to expect. I had a very in-depth conversation with all of the guys that are involved, and they've embraced him. He's embraced them, and it's been a smooth transition so far.
Did he come in ready?
He came in as ready as you would expect somebody to be who hasn't played in a year and a half. His conditioning was good. I was very pleased with that. And his wanting to learn our system and committing to that has been really good.
What can he add to the the dynamic in the backfield?
The only thing that I can go with is what he's done in the past that I've seen. We still have things to learn. He still has things he has to learn. So when he has a better grasp of our system, then it'll be easier to really answer that question.
How does Sanders look?
Oh,
he's
great.
Are you as amazed as everybody?
It's amazing. It's amazing. He is physically a freak because he's recovered so fast and he's ready to go.
Is there a maximum number of running backs you feel comfortable
Absolutely
using?
Not. Absolutely not.
The more the merrier?
Absolutely not. I mean, just another formation to dream of.
The depth of your running back core, is it unusual? Is it something that gives you a lot of confidence? I mean, it sounds like you're a happy guy, right?
I'm always happy. It doesn't matter. I'm going to find some happiness. The biggest thing is that you really should have, in a program of this caliber, 6 scholarship athletes at running back. That's the reality of it. We're very, very pleased with the depth that we have and think that we'll continue to just have those guys grow and try to get them on the field as much as we can and use personnel groups and formations to get that done.
How's Dominique Pryor? In terms of the pace of Dyer picking up the offense, are you having to spoon feed him? Do you feel like he's soaking it up?
He's doing a really good job. He's very attentive in the meetings. And then we have several prayer meetings one-on-one to make sure that he's able to catch up. And quite frankly, his teammates that are in the same room with him do a really good job of peer teaching.
Did you say player meetings or prayer meetings?
Both.
His talent level, how talented is Dyer?
Are you really serious on that question?
Your opinion.
I think he's a really good player. He's a guy that's been a 2,000-yard rusher and arguably one of the best leagues in the country. And so you can see that. You see those flashes when he makes plays. But he's the beauty of it is that he's got guys that can do those kind of things with him. So it really pushes him to do even better.
How's Dominique?
Dominique's doing good. Yeah. He's doing good. He's back. He's 100%. He had a great spring. He's transitioned from the spring to the fall very smoothly. So we're real happy with him too.
Kenny, this is the first time he's been a running back for a full year, correct? I mean, you had him in the spring.
Well, I guess you're right.
I mean, spring and fall,
right,
totally.
Right, and he's thoroughly immersed in it. He understands that that's what he is, and he's embraced it
Doesn't
tremendously.
Doesn't that make a difference, though?
It does. It does. I think he's been committed to it for over going into 2 years now.
What's going to be different from Dominique that we didn't see when we last actually saw him on the field?
I think that when you're a senior, that clock is running really, really fast. And even though he has another year, you always know that guys are going to play that year, their senior year, as best they can because they all want to go to the next level. So with